My dear nerds, I am dying over here. I'm going through such a massive heat wave, it's not even funny. I'm sweating, I think, 2 liters of water per day, which, you know, for all my American nerds, let me convert, that's like 6 cans of Coke, which is a lot. And the fact that my little YouTube studio is basically a closet which doesn't have any air conditioning, well, that kind of just adds to the torture. But life is torture. Life has always been torture, so join me by the fireplace here. Look how beautiful it is. But the reason why I'm making this video right now, and the reason why I actually postponed my Mio A30 review, which I've actually been in the middle of working on before I had to make this one, is because the guys at muOS released what's, in my opinion, probably one of the most important updates that they can ever release for, you know, muOS. Now, I have to set the expectations straight. This is an incremental update, meaning that you won't have many visible changes, but my god, does it not make things way better. And, you know, they did a lot of things, I'm not gonna cover all of them, they did backend changes, a lot of this, a lot of that, but there are 4 things specifically that I've been asking for such a flipping long time. I've been begging for these, I've been pleading with them. The 4 things that I really love that they did here is, one, they sort of implemented, quote unquote, kind of OTA updates, which I'm gonna describe later because they're not really OTA updates, but they are non-destructive updates, which is immensely important. The second thing that they did is you can now switch between the D-pad and the virtual thumbstick by pressing the power button, exactly how the stock OS does it. This actually allows you to play the smarter retro consoles that you would usually not really have a good experience with. The SP, for example, doesn't have thumbsticks. Well, now this makes it way more easier to play things like PSP, N64, and quite a few others, Dreamcast, and so on. The third thing that they did is that they finally fixed the HDMI out audio issue, which I talked about in my last clip.
The audio works now, which makes me super happy. And I actually loaded Super Mario 64, but this is actually the PSP port, so not the N64, and it seems to work flawlessly. The question is, will we have a permanent audio brick after I disconnect this bad boy? This is the moment of truth. Okay. And we have sound. Mwahaha.
And if you haven't seen my last video on muOS, you really need to watch it because it's not really old, it's not obsolete. In fact, I would say that this video right here is a direct continuation of that. So in order for you to have more context, I really encourage you, go watch that video, I'm gonna put it in a pinned comment, and then come back to this one. This will allow you to have complete context over this custom firmware and over the latest changes. And last but not least, what they did is they finally added a Moonlight app. So for all you fine nerds that constantly asked me, Vlad, how the flip did you play Witcher 3 on, you know, your RG35XXH? Because I've had some B-roll with me playing Witcher 3 on the RG35XXH, and I've had Steam there and, you know, other things that are just awesome to see on such a device. Well, the answer to that is and always was Moonlight. And for context, Moonlight is an app which allows you to stream your PC to basically any handheld device that has the Moonlight client. In this particular situation, Moonlight now comes pre-installed with the latest muOS update. So you can technically play, I don't know, whatever you play on your PC on a screen so small that it destroys your eyesight, which is you know, bad for you, but pretty flipping awesome from a proof of concept point of view. So yeah, they did all of these things, but let's now go into a bit more detail because each feature has things worth discussing about. So you might be wondering, why the flip am I saying OTA updates? Because muOS doesn't support OTA updates. Well, yes and no. Because now muOS supports non-destructive updates, which means that we can now update the system without having to nuke the SD card. And God knows I've nuked so many SD cards lately that I should be part of the G7 group of countries. It's simply exhausting to have to annihilate any sort of setup that you do on a card just to update the system. I've always found it stupid. I will always find it stupid. It's equally as stupid when Anbernic does it with their stock OS. It was equally as stupid when muOS did it, and it's equally as stupid when any other custom firmware does it. But muOS, thankfully, thank your god of choice that they now allow us to install updates without going through all this hell, okay? Now we have the option of just taking a zip file from their GitHub, and we have to put that zip file in a folder that we conveniently have to call archive in all caps, and then you just plop that zip file onto, you know, the SD card that you're using for whatever muOS supported handheld you play on. Then you put your card back in the handheld, you go in the applications section, then you go to archive manager, and the update should automatically appear. And after you click on it, it simply installs, and you get to keep basically all of the things that you wasted hours and hours on, like your saved games, your customizations, everything that makes you feel like you're going through hell if you have to reinstall after each update. And the update process is thus so flipping easy now. You don't have to reinstall everything, you don't have to cry on the inside, you don't have to, you know, bust your brain over remaking your entire setup. This is something which I've always asked for, and I know you asked for as well. And even though this is not technically over the air, this is one half of the logic of over the air updates that they will eventually implement, because they nailed down the logic that allows you to install an update on top of a current muOS install, which I would argue is the most complicated part, because you can corrupt an installation fairly easily. Now that they have this nailed down, we can all breathe a sigh of relief. What they have to do now, and this is the easier part, I would say, again, this is my humble opinion, I'm not sure if this is the case, they just have to nail down a distribution system. And by that I mean they have to figure out how you can download it directly on your device, so this logic that we have now with the update installation can take place. The only thing that we're doing manually is that we're taking the update and we plop it on the SD card. Having you know, your RG35XXSP or H downloaded from somewhere is, I would argue, the easy part. So I'm pretty convinced that we will see legit OTA updates in the next, I don't know, one or two or at most three muOS updates. But currently, we can update in a non-destructive way, which is, it's beautiful. I can't understate this. How many times did you lose your setup by updating? Not anymore, mother flipper! Not anymore! And we have to rejoice with this. It's one of the best things, you know, to have. As far as the, you know, a hotkey that allows you to change the D-pad to a virtual thumbstick, well, this just makes all Anbernic devices that muOS supports, which don't have thumbsticks, just way better. Because now you can play, you know, the more advanced 3D systems without being limited by the number of buttons that you have. You can play way more PSP, not all of them, because some games require you to use both the D-pad and the joystick at once, but you can play a lot of PSP games, or N64, or flipping Dreamcast. Now you can do this. Now you can actually enjoy this extra portfolio of games on something like the RG35XXSP, which I think is beautiful. Before this, I actually didn't even try to, you know, play these handhelds. It just felt like torture. What was I gonna do? Go into the RetroArch settings and remap everything like a flipping monkey? I don't want to do that, and neither should you. This makes things easier. If you ask me, this is still sort of a hack, because the ideal device, well, in my opinion, should still have thumbsticks, because thumbsticks are extra input methods and we can never have enough of those. But if you're one of those guys that are happy that the RG35XXSP doesn't have thumbsticks, then you should flipping celebrate over this update. You should be so happy. There's not one thing, not one thing that StockOS has now that muOS can't do or doesn't already have implemented. StockOS and Anbernic, you know, can quite frankly learn from muOS. And last but certainly not least, my dear nerds, this version of muOS actually includes the cutest Moonlight app that I ever saw. It has a very nice graphical user interface. It's actually very easy to use. I'm a sucker for friendliness, and this app just screams fluffy and wholesome. I ran the big picture mode of SteamOS. I ran quite a few games that, you know, were, for all intents and purposes, desktop Windows games. Moonlight, for those who don't know, is an app that allows you to stream your desktop and every flipping game that you can imagine that you have on your PC onto any, you know, handheld device which has the client side of Moonlight built into it. And this allows you to play everything. If you want to play, I know, Grand Theft Auto 5 on this, you can, because Moonlight also uses the buttons as a way to interact with that game. So whatever you have on your PC, you now can, you know, play on your Ambernic device on a small screen through Moonlight if that's what you want. I'll be honest, it isn't comfortable to use Moonlight on such small screens, but as a proof of concept, because I'm a nerd and because you are a nerd, it's so flipping amazing to see heavy games like, I know, what do kids play lately? I'm gonna say Portal 2, I'm still stuck in that era. If you want to play Portal 2, when you see it on this screen, it's just beautiful, you know, it's, you can't help yourself but just smile. In that moment, your soul is happy, your inner nerd is vibrating with tingliness and with happiness. And I would argue that's one of the best parts of this hobby. So now you can do this on muOS through Moonlight. Previously, running Moonlight was a pain in the backside, but now it's pretty much very convenient and easy. And yeah, my dear nerds, this is basically it. This is a small incremental update, but these features I figured, maybe I'm wrong, maybe you might think I'm an idiot, but I think these features were worth talking about. They warranted a video. They warranted me to sweat. Look at this hand. Do you see? They warranted me to sweat like a flipping elephant in the savannah just for us to talk about this. And I'm glad that I did, because I just wanted to cry in a corner when I think about how many SD cards I nuked for new installations over the last year. It's not even funny, I just wanted to crawl in the fetus position and, you know, hug myself. But thankfully, I might not have to do this anymore. Not with the possibility that we now have to, you know, apply non-destructive updates. So, my dear nerd, install this. You literally won't lose anything if you already have muOS. If you don't have muOS, you have to install the Refried Beans update, which is considered the main update, and then you install this Baked Beans update. Don't ask me why they name them like this. I have no idea. I just accepted it. In case you don't have muOS, you have to go through this process. Then you just update any, you know, future update that comes along in the same way, or maybe through OTA, who the flip knows. But anyway, my dear nerds, if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. Like I said in previous clips, I hate saying this. Whenever YouTubers say this, I just honestly click away. Don't you dare to click away, by the way. But I have to say this, because apparently this helps and it's a necessary evil. So if you love what I do here, subscribe, press the like button, do all that good stuff. And if you really like what I do, like, you know, which is almost high school crush kind of like, then feel free to become one of my personal direct supporters, just like these guys. These guys are one of the most awesome people that I can think of. These are just a handful of people that I feature in every episode of mine, and they will always be in every episode of mine. And you can become one of them through either becoming a channel member or a Patreon. If you decide to support me directly, I will love you forever. This is not negotiable. This is not optional. I will love you forever. If I see you in real life, I'm gonna talk your flipping ears off until you get bored of me. But I don't want you to feel like, you know, you're cast aside like a piece of used toilet paper if you don't support me. I love you anyway, even if you don't support me. If you subscribe, if you don't subscribe, you are not my friend. If you subscribe, I will give you all the hugs in the world. Again, this is not negotiable. This is not, oh, do I want a hug from Vlad or not? No, you will get all the hugs. All of them. But in any case, my sweet, fleshy, meatbag-like nerds, this is all from me. As always, I love you very much. I hope you know this. And see you in the next video. Bye.